Hi friends, good morning. This is Pinoy IT How To coming back. So this morning we will perform a CPU maintenance check. So last night I heard an abnormal noise or sound coming from the fan. So I decided to turn off the laptop and perform my maintenance check this morning. So here is the location of the CPU or the central processing unit or the microprocessor. Okay, so this is the CPU or the microprocessor. Okay, this portion. So this is the fan, this one. So as you can see, there is already lots of dust inside the fan. So when the fan stop working, it will overheat the CPU and it will cause problem on the CPU, or it will damage the CPU eventually, or the main board. So it is very important to perform a maintenance check, especially the fan. So in this case, we need to clean this fan, then after that we will turn on the laptop just to make sure, because if we will not check the fan and just use it, eventually it will damage the CPU or the main board. Okay, so usually this is the problem of most laptop which are used for long time already because of the accumulation of the dust of the fan and the exhaust. Also here you see there is already dust. Okay, so what we will do now is to remove this fan and clean it using a WD-40 cleaner or an alcohol. Okay, so let's get started, guys. There's a hard drive there. That's the Wi-Fi card, right? So this is an old laptop. You see, this is the Windows Vista authenticity sticker. Okay, so we will remove now this fan and we will clean it, guys. Alright, let's do this. Okay, so we have to remove this one. Here is this connection over here. It's a connector. Okay, like that. And then we'll remove the screw. All right, then we'll remove this one. See, guys, there is already a lot lots of dust. Yeah, it's blocking the airways. So we need to remove also the CPU heatsink. Right. See, guys, lots of dust. This is the exhaust and blocking the airways. So if we will not clean this one, it will damage the CPU eventually or the mainboard. Right? Okay, so that's the CPU. Okay, so this is T2330 CPU dual core at 160 GHz. So I am planning this one to replace with T8300. So I'm just waiting the parts. Okay, so as you can see, the heatsink is still good. And it is not dry yet. So what we'll do is just to clean this one and this one. This one, we have to clean this one. Okay. We'll first clean this one. Alright guys, see, I removed the dust using an alcohol, but it is recommended to use the WD-40 cleaner. So because I don't have, so I use the alcohol. You can use it, but make sure when you reinstall this CPU heatsink is dry. Okay, so now it's clean already. See, the dust is already removed from the heatsink. So this is the airways here. This is where the heat from the CPU comes out. Okay, so we'll put it there. So the next thing to clean is this one. This one. I will just spray it. See guys? Now it's clean. So the dust disappeared from the fan. So make sure when you reinstall this one, it is dry. So we need to wait and dry this fan first before we will reinstall it to the laptop. Alright. Okay. All right, guys. So it's clean now and dry. So we will reinstall now the heatsink of the CPU. All right. So put the silicone paste here on the CPU. Silicone paste. I put this silicone compound last 2 years ago, but still it's still working. Still good. Still not dry. So this is okay. Just put it like this and then install back the heatsink. Alright. Alright guys, so we'll tighten the screw. Tighten this screw first and the opposite one. Make sure not to over tight the screw here. then the opposite one. So make sure not to over tight the screw. Okay, and then install back the connection. So next is the fan. See, we already eliminated the dust, and this is clean already and dry. So we will install it back now. Okay. We clean this area first. Okay, and then put back the fan. And screw it. Okay. And then this one. And then put back the connector. Okay, so that's it, guys. That's how we perform a CPU maintenance cleaning or check. So this maintenance is very important of your laptop, because if you will not perform this, it will damage the CPU or your main board, which is usually the cause of problems of most laptops which are used for a long time. Alright, so that's it, guys. So I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on my next video. So we'll close now. See you on my next video, guys. Bye.